Welcome to Section 1 of Introduction to Image Processing. This section provides an overview of typical image processing tasks and some examples of topics that are covered in this course. The first step in almost any image processing task is getting the images into the computer or importing the images into the software that will be used for the processing. One way of doing that is by connecting the computer and the software to a camera. This shows the current image function in the Wolfram language, which captures an image from a camera connected to this computer and imports the image into this Wolfram language system. You can also import images from files on your computer or from the internet. For example, this imports a JPEG image from a file on the internet. JPEG is one of dozens of common image formats. Images can also be generated within the computer. For example, this uses the image function to create an image from a table of numbers. Images can also be created from things displayed on the computer screen. For example, this displays a plot and then uses the rasterize function to convert that display to an image. The image can then be edited or modified like any other image. After an image has been imported, there is a variety of things that can be done to modify the image, either for aesthetic reasons or to prepare the image for further analysis. For example, this shows a manipulate result with controls for modifying the brightness and contrast in an image. Operations for adjusting brightness and contrast are discussed in sections 2 and 3. Contrast and brightness adjustment work by changing the image histogram, which is the distribution of colors and intensities in an image. There are several common operations that involve other modifications of the image histogram. For example, this shows an operation called color transfer or histogram matching, which modifies the distribution of colors in one image to match the distribution of colors in another image. Histogram matching and some related operations are discussed in Section 4. Another group of basic image operations is geometric operations like cropping and rotating and resizing the image. For example, this shows a cropped and rotated version of the sample image created using the image rotate and image trim functions. Here is a manipulate result that shows these geometric operations with sliders to control the amount of cropping and resizing and rotating. Basic geometric operations are covered in Section 8. A key step in many image processing tasks is segmentation, which means separating out different parts of the image. There are many methods of segmentation. This shows segmentation using the binarize function, which separates the image into two segments based on brightness. The result from segmentation is represented here by a black and white image, with the bright segment identified by the white parts of that result and the darker segment identified by the black parts. Once the image has been segmented, there are many things that can be done with it. For example, this picks out the biggest connected components in that segmentation, which in this example are the slices of the pizza. This input uses the component measurements function to count the number of pieces of pizza in that segmentation and give the size of each piece. The general topic of segmentation, and specifically segmentation using the binarize function, are covered in Section 5. It is also worth noting that those last two inputs illustrate an area of image processing called image analysis, where the goal is to get information from the image instead of just modifying the image to get another image. There are many other methods of segmentation. One method is clustering, which can, for example, segment an image by grouping similar colors in an image. This shows segmentation by clustering used to separate the sample image into five segments. The colorize function is used here to display each segment in a contrasting color. Another method of segmentation is watershed segmentation. As an example, this input shows a watershed algorithm used to separate a satellite image into components on opposite sides of a river. Segmentation by clustering is described in Section 7, and other methods of segmentation are described in Section 11. One use of an image segment is as a mask to provide a way to do things to selected parts of an image. For example, this shows a segmentation that separates the pizza from everything else in the image. And this uses that segment as a mask to remove color from everything other than the masked part of the image, so the background becomes black and white, and the pizza remains in color. There are many other things that can be done with color. Here is an input that uses the color distance function to segment the image based on similarity to the color green, which identifies the green things on the pizza. These operations and some basic color theory are discussed in Section 6. Another broad area of image processing is image enhancement, which includes tools for reducing noise in images and for repairing defects in images. For example, here is a noisy version of the sample image, and this input shows smoothing out the noise using a Gaussian filter. There are many other methods of noise reduction. This shows a method called a mean shift filter that does a slightly better job of removing the noise while preserving sharp edges in the image. Image defects can often be corrected using a method called inpainting, which works by filling in defects using colors and textures from the surrounding parts of the image. For inpainting, the part of the image that is to be filled in is identified by a mask. This shows inpainting used with a mask that identifies everything other than the pizza as the part of the image that is to be filled in, which basically removes the background. With a few adjustments, the background can also be filled in with more pizza. Tools for noise reduction and other image enhancements are discussed in Section 9. Section 10 covers the general topic of feature detection. In many applications, it is important to identify basic features of an image, like lines and edges. For example, this shows the image lines function used to detect lines in an image. In this example, those lines could be useful for subsequent operations, such as removing perspective distortion. Depending on the application, almost anything in an image could be a feature. For example, this uses the image keypoints function to identify a certain class of potentially interesting features in an image. Those features could be important in a variety of applications, such as, for example, trimming the image based on the locations of features. Section 12 describes a diverse class of operations that use ideas from mathematical morphology, which typically means that these operations work by considering relationships between neighboring locations in an image. For example, this shows a morphological operation called a top hat transform used to remove the large features and the variation in background shading from an image. The result is an image that emphasizes the finer details of the original image. This shows another morphological operation called geodesic dilation, which is used here to reconstruct two paths through a circuit based on a marker image that identifies starting points on those two paths. A particularly active area of new development in image processing is application of machine learning, which is covered in Section 13. For example, this shows the Find Faces function, which uses a machine learning algorithm to find human faces in an image. Here is another example. This shows the Image Identify function, which uses a machine learning algorithm that has been trained to identify the main object in an image. In addition to these built-in functions, there is a large and growing collection of functions in the Wolfram Neural Net repository. Neural nets are a common method used in machine learning. Section 13 includes several examples from the Neural Net repository. The final section, Section 14, is a set of examples chosen to illustrate how the techniques covered in earlier sections can be used in complete applications. This shows stabilization of a shaky video, which is one of the examples in Section 14. That's the end of the examples for this section. Here is the outline for this course, which is designed to use practical examples to provide a foundation for solving problems in image processing.